Compared to the unbridled optimism it started with, the 20th century has been one long trip of misery, cruelty and human suffering. Now a new scourge has risen in Russia. The fascist Germanophile dictatorship of Mikhail Oktan. Politically, the regime is extremely centered around the idea that the Germans are strong and thus always correct. This is the basis of Oktan's fascist principles, antisemitism and anti-Bolshevism. He has built a cult of personality around himself similar to Mussolini or you-know-who, created German-style secret police, established youth brigades and started a campaign of Russification. Minorities like the Tatars have been especially targeted for Russification since the mid-60s with mixed results. Bolsheviks are either terrorized or shot, and for the Jews, life is uncertain and getting an opportunity to leave the nation is like a gift from God. Under Oktan, Russia is a feudal kleptocracy. He effectively runs the country like a mafia boss with his loyalist anti-Semitic fascist provincial warlords, governors, generals and other strongmen having total freedom to rule as they wish in their regions with their own laws and to extort the people for increasing amounts of money. In return they have to follow basic laws according to Oktan's fascist principles, fill his coffers and remain loyal to him, which they do because of their greed. He is also shrewd enough to keep the key ports, railways and other important assets under his personal command to control the nation and his feudal lords. Apart from strongmen, Oktan has also sold huge portions of lands to rich companies as corporate exclaves. These are nothing but feudal realms controlled by these corporations. They have full authority to make and enforce whatever laws they wish. Looking at this system, we can easily understand how Oktan, a mere German collaborator, managed to get so many greedy warlords to follow him and why the group was so successful in conquering Russia within a decade. Thus under Oktan, Russia has no middle class. The lower classes work, toil and pay taxes while the upper classes are all those who are loyal to Oktan. For the poor, the unloyal and those hated by the regime, life is a daily struggle to put food on the table. An escaped Jewish landowner family narrates that the local lords tax collectors would come to their estate more than once to collect double and triple taxes. All complaints fell on deaf ears and would get lost in the corrupt bureaucracy. Life for the peasants isn't any better either. Whatever they grow must be sold in the markets individually since unions aren't allowed. However, to get to the market, one must pay bribes to everyone along the way, from the toll booth collectors to the market dealers who extort them for money. For the workers, life is a cycle of getting paid extremely minimum wages and then having to pay extravagant taxes, leaving barely enough money to get one meal a day. Under Oktan's rule, there is no such thing as a minimum wage, and his warlords and business tycoons are free to set whatever wages they like. Thus Mikhail Oktan now rules the largest country in the world in this fashion. But life goes on. Interestingly, women have found greater independence in this new state, because the rich women are too rich to listen to anyone and the poor women have to work along with the men to survive daily, thus making them equal to their man.